What's going on, everybody? My name is Michael Anthony, and today I'm going to show you exactly how to calibrate your monitor so that when you edit images that look like this, they don't print looking like this. All right, before we get started, there's something that we're going to need, okay? This is a calibration tool. This is made by a company called Xrite. This is the i1 display profiler. You can use a variety of different calibration tools, but I found this one and the one by DataColor, which I will put a link to in the description below, to be the most accurate. Now, when you guys go ahead and get this tool, you're gonna plug it into your computer. I'm using a MacBook Pro here, so I've got a dongle. The USB-A connector is connected to the dongle. The dongle is connected to the computer, and then we are ready to roll. You have to download the software that accompanies this device, and then go ahead and open that up. Right when we open that software, we're gonna go ahead and click display profiling. We're gonna get to this screen right here. I'm gonna go ahead and maximize it so that we have it here. Now on the actual device, I have to turn this and open it so that the glass part of the target right here is facing outward, right? So that we can see it and it's visible. And just put that aside for a second here. Then I'm gonna go ahead and adjust my settings right here. And you can see there's a lot of different settings in here. I always keep these settings just at whatever they're default settings are, because it is auto detecting what the native display settings of the display are, right? So then when I come in here now, I'm gonna go ahead and select my white point. I always just keep this again at default. I'm gonna keep it at 6,500. In this instance right here, my luminance. Now this is something you can control and you can change to whatever fits you. For right now, I'm gonna keep it at native, right? Because I wanna keep it at the native brightness of the screen. But it is recommended to use a lower brightness setting. So 120 is probably recommended if you're editing in a controlled room where it's gonna be dark and you can focus directly on the screen. So now what I'm gonna do in here, I'm gonna keep my gamma at the default. I'm gonna go ahead and click next. I'm gonna go ahead and click start measurement. And then when we get to this screen, now what I have to do is I have to take my target. I have to go ahead, you can slide, by the way, the counterweight, right? I have to hang this over the edge of the display, and I'm gonna go ahead and put the color target with the glass facing the screen right in the center of the display over the computer icon, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of this notification here, and I'm just gonna click next. Now, it's gonna do a couple of simple adjustments real quick. Okay, so now once this finishes, real important, okay? Do not unplug the device from the computer. That will make you have to do the entire process all over again, okay? So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take this off, I'm gonna close it. Once I close it, then it gives me the okay to proceed. Then I'm gonna go ahead and click next, okay? It's gonna say measurement successfully completed. Click save to keep your measurement for future use. Click next to continue on to the next step. Okay, now in here, when we get to this screen, we have to go to the next step here. It's a little misleading because now we're on this screen and we have to click save profile, okay? On that previous screen, you actually do have to click next prior to being able to click save. It's just a bug in the software. It's been there for years, but that's how you do it, right? So now once we get here, you can name your profile. I just keep mine the default, which is defaults to the date. Click save profile. Profile saved successfully, click OK to dismiss this dialog and click home. So now what we're gonna do is I wanna show you here, you can compare the before and after. Mine was already calibrated, but the important part for you to understand is that you have to update this at least once a month. That is the minimum recommended time frame between updating this, because your display will change as it gets older and it wears. You have to continuously recalibrate it because it will fall out of calibration, right? So if you wanted to see prior to this, I don't know if I could show you this, but if this is the first time you do this, right, that before and after will be significantly different, right? So when you do that, then you're gonna see that it's a completely different profile and you're gonna see why your prints have not looked correct from the start. So this is a really good way to make sure that your prints are consistent. I think it's an important, and in fact, I think it's an essential part of your workflow as a professional photographer. Make sure you keep your calibration updated and then set a reminder to continuously update it once a month at least. That's all I have for you guys today. If you like this video, please leave a comment down below letting me know. If there's anything that you guys suggest or you guys want us to talk about in the future, please also feel free to send me an email at mike@elevateyourphotography.com. That is all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much, and we'll catch you on the next one.